Welcome to this lecture. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about MEMS sensors, where we have discussed about first the silicon capacitive sensor, accelerometer, and then piezoresistive sensors, pressure sensors we have discussed. In this lecture, we will discuss about the conductometric gas sensors, and one is optical sensors. This conductometric gas sensors is based on the reversible gas absorption mechanism that occur on the surface sensor surface. This is the sense active area of the sensor. The absorbed gas atoms, whatever gas atoms will be absorbed by this active area, that will inject electron into the semiconductor material, or they will extract electron from the semiconductor materials. It will depend on whether they are reducing or oxidizing respectively. If they are oxidizing, it's a process oxidizing, then they will extract the electrons from the semiconductor material. They will reduce the number of electrons. If it's a reducing process, in that case they will inject the electrons into this semiconductor material. Hence, they will change the conductivity of this material. The electrons absorb or extract by the gas atoms, that will depend on the amount of gas, how much atoms are present, particular atoms are present in the gas. So, number of electrons absorb or release, that will depend on number of atoms available in the gas, and hence the conductivity of this material, that will depend on the atoms, particular gas atoms available in the environment. The application of conductometric gas sensors are environmental monitoring, to measure about the different type of gases in the environmental, for exhaust gas sensing in the automobile, to check if how many carbon monoxide it's releasing or other harmful product it is releasing, air conditioning in the airplanes, spacecraft, for measure the different gases, houses and the sensing network, for ethanol for breath analyzer and odor sensing the food control applications. The material used for conductometric gas sensors are the film of metal oxide such as SNO2 or titanium oxides. The fabrication process using the crystalline SNO2 nanobells. What is nanobells are synthesized by the thermal evaporation of oxide powder under the controlled condition in absence of any catalyst. The four steps are for this conductometric gas sensor reactions are, first is pre-absorption of the oxygen on semiconductor material surface. Before measuring, before applying the gas, first of all, what the procedure? First, this active area that will pre-absorb the oxygen gas on the semiconducting material surface. Then it will absorb the specific gas. The reaction between the oxygen and the absorbed gas will take place. According to that, the reaction, how much the atoms are present in that gas. Gas atoms are present in the environment, the conductivity will change and then deabsorb the reactant gas on the surface. So it is again ready for the repeating the same process and for using measurement of the gas content. Next is fiber optic sensors. What is this? A fiber optics has a plastic or glass fiber core with a cladding. A center core and outside is a cladding. We have already studied earlier. So use of sense is, it may be used to sense any quantity that change the intensity, wavelength, polarization, phase or transit time of the light passing through it. So any quantity that change either intensity of the light, wavelength, polarization, phase or transit time of a light passing through it, that quantity can be measured using fiber optic sensors. Typical measurement of fiber optic sensors are, we can measure the pressure, temperature, electric and magnetic current, and strain or a similar quantity can be measured, because this quantity can change this intensity, wavelength, polarization, phase or transit time of the light. Advantages of fiber optic sensors are, they are free from magnetic interference. It's a major advantage, main advantage of using fiber optic sensors, because it's free from electromagnetic interference. It's wide bandwidth because of an optical range. It's compact, versatile and economical. Its sensitivity is very higher for in case of fiber optic sensors. It can withstand with high temperature and harsh environment also, because it's free from, it's very less, there is very less effect of temperature and harsh environment on this optical sensors. So what is the principle of optical sensor? The knowing grating, knowing the grating period spacing D, what is D? Grating period spacing D and effective refractive index REF. If these two is known, then the Bragg's wavelength is given by lambda equals to REF multiplied by del. Or D spacing, that is grating period spacing. These is all same. These are D and the del are same. The wavelength will shift with the change in the effective refracting index or the spacing of the grating. If any one quantity, if effective refracting index is change, or if the grating period is spacing is change, the wavelength then change. So by measuring the wavelength, we can measure these two quantities. Such change can be caused when the grating area is subjected to mechanical or thermal load. So the grating period spacing can be changed because of the mechanical or thermal load. If delta epsilon is the change in the mechanical strain due to a mechanical load and delta T is the change in the temperature due to thermal load, then these change can be related to the change in the Bragg's wavelength. By this equation, del lambda equals to alpha del epsilon plus beta del T. And what is alpha and beta? Alpha lambda B into 1 minus PC, or beta equal to lambda B alpha A plus alpha B. What is this alpha and beta and PC? PC is the strain optic constant, alpha is the thermal expansion coefficient, and beta is a thermal optic coefficient of the fiber. These are the references. Thank you.